The concept of a digital wallet is one that's been discussed in the technology industry for over 20 years now. Most of the conversation centers around trying to make it easy to make payments online. Instead of having to remember the 16 digits in your credit card and type them into a checkout page every time you want to buy something, you could simply have them populated from an online wallet. But payments and money are not the only things. They carry lots of other cards as well. For example, some form of government ID with them, typically a driver's license, although you rarely use it to demonstrate your eligibility to operate a motor vehicle and more often use it to demonstrate that you are in fact who you say you are, which has also become recently very important online. If you want to open up a bank account or access your student records or file your taxes online, you need to prove you are who you say you are before you get access to those kinds of services. And so there's a whole new category of digital wallets that are emerging that are around use cases that have nothing to do with payments or money and have to do with the other cards that you carry in your wallet. Now, there's a lot of advantages of digital wallets compared to traditional wallets. You don't necessarily need to share everything that's on the card every time you present it. So let's say that I wanted to buy a bottle of wine. I'd have to prove that I'm over the age of 21. I'd have to share my driver's license, which exposes all kinds of other personally identifiable information. But with a digital wallet, I might just share that I've been verified to be over the age of 21, which is really all the retailer needs to know and should care about. Another advantage of a digital wallet is that it's electronic, so you can store as many cards as you want to in it, even those that are very infrequently used. Take something like your social security card. Another example might be a passport. The digital wallets also are not constrained by the physical dimensions of a typical wallet, so you can carry big documents in them as well. Same concept applies for professional licenses. Really, proof of any kind of occupation could be stored in a digital wallet. Digital wallets also can store bulky documents. So as you can see, there are dozens and dozens of use cases for digital wallets. But what's amazing is even though these technologies have been around for a couple decades, there's relatively low levels of adoption. At ID.me, we think that's because of the way they've been implemented. So we're pioneering a new model that leads with privacy and puts the customer in control of what information is shared and with who. And we think this new customer-centric model is the key to unlocking massive adoption in these amazing technologies.